Time to tag you. I'm going to tag you. Time to tag you. Time to tag you. Another episode of Tag Time. Welcome to Tag Studio for Tag Time. I'm your host, Halima Sadia. Today, I'm going to tag you another episode of Tag Time. As we are celebrating International Women Day today, I am going to talk about women empowerment, and we are going to talk to our role model in the community for women empowerment. I'm talking about Mokshi Virk and Mala Sharma Singh. Welcome to my show.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.
You're both very prominent in the community and you're working for the women empowerment. What's your take on that, Mokshi?
I would say that it's such a good day to be here in your studio celebrating International Women's Day. I think it's been a long journey and we are so proud to be here. I think International Women's Day symbolizes that we have to inspire and support each other. When we talk about equality, I think this is a day where we need to all get together and talk about it and share and celebrate it.
Mala, what would you like to share about that?
Well, definitely, I agree with Mokshi. This year's theme for International Women's Day is Press for Progress. And that's what's been happening over the years. We've advanced in so many ways as women together. You know, with the Me Too movement and everything that's happening, it's bringing awareness to the world that women over the years have been taken advantage of, and they've kept silent. Now the elephant in the room is now out, and they're standing up for themselves and speaking out of injustices that are being done to them. So I think this is a very, very special day today, International Women's Day, because so much has happened in the last couple of years, and we have come very far. We are pressing for progress. We're going to continue to press for progress. And that's not to say that there aren't any good men in the world, that all men are bad. We have fathers. We all love our fathers. Our fathers are good. But there are good and bad in the world, and even women good and bad in the world. But we have to build awareness of who is doing wrong and come forward. And I think International Women's Day this year is very, very powerful because all of this is being brought to the forefront.
And when we talk about International Women's Day, we talk about the unity of the women around the world. Like we are basically sharing a lot of our personality traits, regardless of the geographical differences, the same way as human community does. So I would like to know your contribution, since you're very active, both of you are very active in the community. What are you pulling into the community? What are your works? What are your participation? How would you like to share with us?
I would say, Halima ji, as women, we wear multiple hats. We are a woman, we are a mother, we are a wife, a career woman. There's so many hats that we wear. So I think it's always challenging to balance between the work and your home and your family life. So what we are trying to do is, on this special day, International Women's Day, we like to get together, celebrate. We are actually planning to do some events so that we can recognize some of the women who have been contributing in our community, the work, the good work that they are doing, and the people who they can inspire, who they can support. This is what we are trying to do in the community. And personally, I believe that once you've gone through the struggle, you've actually gone through the journey, you are more stronger, you can motivate others, you can really mentor people who are new, they're struggling, you can be a role model for them.
You can talk about the process that everybody goes through with certain products. So for that matter, you actually do you celebrate an event which is going to happen on 24th of March for International Women's Day. So coming to the event, since they are both the symbol of women empowerment and they work for the women, so Mala, what would you like to talk about your event, which is your contribution towards women?
Well, it started off to be just a small event. I was planning to just have it in a small room, and it grew and grew and grew. And now all the media is contacting us. It's tomorrow at the Rose Garden Banquet Hall. And for International Women's Day, we wanted to really put on the pedestal the women who tirelessly contribute from all walks of life, all races, all nationalities. So I'm proud to say we have members flying in from the United Nations coming. We have women from Los Angeles. We have women flying from Africa. Prabha is coming from Dubai. So it's really put our show on the world map. And we're very proud that TAG TV is also going to be there. And you also, you're such a beautiful role model for all women. Not only are you beautiful by face, you're beautiful by heart. And we're very honored to also honor you tomorrow on stage. And we have the mayor of Brampton who will be there, Linda Jeffrey, and also some very prominent women in our community who are going to be honored on stage. Also, Mukshi, I believe in women uplifting each other. The main problem I find with our community is people smile in people's faces, and the moment they turn their back, they're gossiping and they're putting people down. I don't believe in that. If I call you a friend to your face, behind your back, I'll say good things. And I think women should change that. No time for gossip, no time for idle. Put your hands to do something good for the community. Build each other up. And this is what International Women's Day is all about. If we don't elevate each other, who will?
Mukshi, you had been recognized in another forum also. So would you like to talk about a little bit about that award and your appreciation?
Sure. Thank you. Yes, I have been just awarded a Community Support Award, Appreciation Award from Absolutely Fabulous Women 40 over 40. So it was an honor, and I'm so humbled to get that award. It's good to feel, good to get an award, because it really makes you feel that you, the work that you're doing in the community is being recognized. And you know what? When I talk about getting a recognition, I believe that when we started in 2013 for the first time to actually celebrate International Women's Day, I never knew that that we'll be going this far. And this year in 2016, this is actually, 2018, sorry, this is our sixth annual Celebrating Womanhood Gala that we'll be celebrating. And again, we'll be recognizing some of the women heroes who have really worked tirelessly, and they are role model for other women. We'll be giving a Women Heroes Awards.
So what was the inspiration behind both of yours? Because you arrange an event, and you got an award from another forum. So what inspired you to do that? What were the reasons which provoked you to have something to award the women around you?
Well, my inspiration, I've done this function actually in my mother's name. My mother is Dani Sharma, and there's a Divine Light Award that I'm awarding to the top International Woman of the Year. And my mother was a very powerful woman politically in Canada. She was the right hand to the Minister of Attorney General. And we came to Canada in 1970. My father came in 67 and we came in 70. And from 1977, my mom has been promoting events for women through the government. And we had an organization on Gerrard Street where we brought the women together, we empowered them, we had tea sessions. So this is going back to 1977. And I really, really think that the inspiration for me to carry on her good name, she died of cancer at the age of 64. But she did so much good in her life and did so much to give back to the community that she lived 10 lifetimes, the amount of work she did. So I'm only minuscule compared to my mother, but she is my inspiration for doing this show.
So what would you like to say about that, Mukshi?
Yes, so I would like to say that when I thought about organizing the International Women's Day, my only reason was that as a newcomer, as an immigrant, or as a citizen also, as women, there's so many challenges that you face, and you're always looking to connect and interact with people. So I thought maybe we can have an organization where we are supporting women initiatives, and that's how we started with this non-profit organization. It's called Indo-Canadian Arts and Culture Initiative. The purpose was to, first of all, recognize some of the women. You know, when you asked me why, what was the inspiration was the women who have struggled, and today they are role model. They've achieved success in their career. So we picked up some categories that under those categories, if somebody has started small and today they are big, they're successful, so why not acknowledge them, recognize them? Because honestly, if I'm getting a recognition in front of my family and friends, it's a big honor. And I got that award, and I know that what I felt, so I know I want to pass on that legacy. That legacy should move on. We should recognize some people.
Mala, what would you say, that how much it is good for a woman to be recognized while she's working so multiple tasks and yes, doing a lot of contribution, how it feels?
Well, I've had a lot of women who are involved with this show tomorrow, just call and say they're so honored and they feel so moved and they've never been recognized, and some of them are just housewives. We have to realize that the mother and the woman of the home is the foundation, and her job is just as important as somebody working in a high position in the corporate world. A mother is the foundation of a house. She uplifts her husband, she teaches her children. So we have mothers that are being awarded also. So I firmly believe that honoring someone and giving them a little bit of a pedestal for us to look up at them gives them a little boost in life and makes them feel good, and they deserve it.
So when we talk about International Women's Day, and we are living in Canada, so we live in a multicultural society. Mokshi, what do you see, are the differences more or the unity? What are the points where we can unite ourselves and we can appreciate each other around the world?
You know what, women, whether it's in India or in Canada or any other country, they play the same role. They are a mother, just like Mala mentioned. A mother is the foundation of a home, so she has to play multiple roles, but the most important is being a housewife and a mother. And I believe that if they are strong and if they get a lot of support at home, they can really achieve big. And that's what we like to recognize. I think International Women's Day is just like a reminder to us that, you know, give some time to yourself. You should celebrate your life. You have such a good friends, family to support you. So this is your time. Celebrate, inspire others, motivate others, be a role model for others. So that's what our purpose is, to recognize and celebrate Women's Day.
So Mala, when you are having an international award ceremony, so what was the reason that you thought that it should be international? What do you think, what are the unifying forces, what are the unifying points among the different nationalities, but being women?
Well, as our Prime Minister Justin Trudeau wisely says, there is unity and diversity. And in our country, we have a big range of multicultural people. So I know a lot of groups are having it just amongst themselves, but I firmly believe that we should also reflect what Canada is, and Canada is multicultural. So on that day, we're going to be having people from all walks of life and all races all over Canada. And I also believe, like my mother also taught me this as a small child, is that we are one universal family. We may be Hindu, we may be Muslim, we may be Christian, we may be Roman Catholic, we may be different colors, but we all belong to one source, no matter what we call him. And being women, we're also very powerful, even more so than men, because we can create. A man can't create a child, a woman can. And that's the ultimate power that the higher source has bestowed upon us, to give us the power to create. So I'm really excited that it's a multicultural event and we have people coming from everywhere. And I think it's going to be an awesome International Women's Day, and we're really happy that you're going to be there also.
Thank you. So I would like both of you to give, before we just sum up our show today, any message you want to convey to the women today through us.
So just like we talk about diversity in Canada, I just wanted to add another point, that even in our event that we are planning, we are doing on March 24th, we've invited different nationalities to be a part of it. And for last few years, we have been actually recognizing some of the women heroes from different cultures as well. So African, European, so different cultures. But again, they were role model. Just to give an example, we had a woman award winner in construction business. Like, that was strange, a woman into construction. CEO is handling all mail. And then we had a York Police regional officer, another woman who is really a tactical officer, she was the first one. So these are the people who have really created like a place for themselves in this community. So that's what we like to recognize. And today, on this special day, I really want to congratulate all the women that move forward, support each other, inspire each other, and be a motivator.
Mala.
Yeah, so my message to all women would be, first of all, you have to love yourself. Take care of yourself, pamper yourself, keep yourself healthy, and then your home, your foundation, always compliment your children, always encourage your children to be the best that they can be. Only speak well of your husband and uplift your husband and uplift your family, because the foundation to everyone is the home. And if the home is empowered by a woman, the husband will go to work happy, not being nagged and upset. The children will come home and be happy. It's our job, first of all, to build a strong foundation in our homes. And then, outside, the world will become a better place. So that's my advice to all women, is to take care of yourself first, take care of your family, and the universe will evolve as it should.
I thank you both for being part of my show today and your great advices to the people.
Thank you for having us, and it's continue your good work with TAG TV.
Thank you. It was really a pleasure having you here.
Our viewers, the role of women is changing. We are living in 21st century. We have worked so far a long way to reach to the point where we are. We are the contributor from home to outside world. It's not that when we talk about housewife, or we talk about entrepreneur, or we talk about an artist. It's just that we have dynamically moved around. We have built the capacity of dynamism in women so that we can handle the situation and the world we are living in 21st century. Empowerment means that you are strong enough to handle the situations you are in. Everybody can have a different situation, but it is only how you handle the situation makes a difference. And when you learn that process, you're a role model for so many people who are still on the road of learning those processes. We share a lot because we share the common world. We are living as human beings. We are equal as women. We are partners of each other to elevate each other and tell that while you are going through a life with a little difference, we experience similar things in a similar situation. With these words, once again, thank you very much and happy International Women's Day for watching this show. Time to tag you. I'm going to tag you. Time to tag you. It's time to tag you. Another episode of Tag Time.